In this video, a patient in a persistent vegetative state is shown. This patient had a severe traumatic brain injury 5 years previously that led to this state. Some elements of the neurological examination are demonstrated here. Responses follow reflexive pathways in the brainstem and are not associated with sensations or other integral faculties. First, we see a lack of responsiveness and no awareness of surroundings by the patient. The eyes are closed. We see there is no response to a voice command and no eye opening. We see that after a pain stimulus is applied, the patient develops a spontaneous clonus and opens the eyes. We see that the patient is not responding to a salvo of loud hand claps. In addition, a nail bed compression stimulus produces a generalized clonus, but again there is no sense of awareness and no grimacing. In this close-up view of the eye, nystagmoid eye movements are seen. Note that the right eye is red due to a filamentary keratitis, which is a well-known complication with patients who are in a permanent vegetative state. We now demonstrate the abnormal phenomenon known as doll's eyes. With head turning, the eyes move back and forth. Furthermore, there is no blinking to threat in both eyes, and no tracking of the reflex hammer. The eyes move erratically, but never fixate. Tapping on the lips produces a positive snout reflex. Here we demonstrate marked spasticity and contractures in the lower extremities. A clonus is easily elicited with a reflex hammer. Reflexes are brisk in the lower limbs, but difficult to elicit in the ankles due to ankle contractures. However, a clonus can still be found. Absence of visual fixation defines the presence of a vegetative state. This can be tested in various ways, but a mirror test is most reliable. In a normal mirror test, as demonstrated here, a large mirror is moved in front of the eyes, causing the patient to move the eyes following every movement of the mirror. This eye fixation is caused by the reflection of the room in the large mirror and cannot be suppressed in a patient with normal responses. It should be pointed out that the use of a pocket mirror with much less reflection will not be sufficient to elicit the response. Then we demonstrate a patient in persistent vegetative state, who shows no evidence of eye fixation when we move a large mirror in front of his eyes. The major neurologic findings are: the eyes are open, but there is no awareness with any provocative test. There is at no point any evidence of expression or comprehension. There is no eye fixation or reproducible tracking of objects. There is evidence of diffuse hemispheric injury, but brainstem reflexes are usually intact. This is a patient with fulminant multiple sclerosis and bilateral plaques in the anterior cingulate cortex. She is shown here approximately 4 weeks after her initial presentation. On neurologic examination, there is marked spasticity of the upper and lower extremities. The left arm is moving, but the movements are uncoordinated and choreiform. The right arm is held in a flexion contracture. She is not responding to loud hand claps or to being called by her name. She is unable to follow a command, even if imitated. As an alternative to the mirror test, an attempt to have her fixate using the first page of a newspaper is not successful. Brief fixation may be seen, but it is not consistent and ambiguous. An attempt to have her track a hand is unsuccessful. However, finally, repeated hand movements to the left by the physician produces a visual fixation, indicating some awareness. The patient can be diagnosed with akinetic mutism. This patient made a dramatic improvement. Within 2 months, she was able to speak, follow a conversation, and take care of most of her daily activities. Criteria for akinetic mutism include: the patient is mute, emotionless, and akinetic. Also, we see the presence of pathologic motor responses, while visual tracking and fixation responses are retained. Please see the accompanying text. This video shows a patient with a massive intraventricular hemorrhage who is in a minimally conscious state. The boundaries of minimally conscious state are poorly defined, but this patient is typical of patients who awaken from coma and are supported by a tracheostomy collar providing oxygen and gastrostomy for nutrition. The patient sleeps most of the day, awakens with slight prodding, and seems to track a finger with repeated attempts. She is localizing a pain stimulus that also produces a grimace. A marked increased tone in the arms with resistance to flexion and bilateral grasp reflexes are noted. This condition did not change over a 3-month period. The outcome for this patient is uncertain. The clinical signs of a minimally conscious state are the presence of intermittent awareness of surroundings, the ability to localize a pain stimulus or reach for an object, the patient may vocalize or verbalize, and the patient sustains eye fixation and looks about. For more descriptive details on these prolonged comatose states, see Chapter 4 of the accompanying text.